The song goes, what goes up must come down. Not inflation, guys. Let's talk about some shopping haul tips to combat inflation. They've tried to fool us with packaging. The boxes have gotten bigger, the contents have gotten smaller, and they hoped that we wouldn't notice. And sometimes there's a unit price in front of the item, if we can remember to look at it, that tells us how much per ounce it is. But some stores we go into that are maybe discount stores don't always have that unit price. So if you don't know how to calculate the unit price, it is the cost divided by how many ounces is in the product. And then you can tell by doing that with each size which one is cheaper per ounce. I was so proud of my 25-year-old the other day. We owned a store for 7.5 years. And before that, I always worked in the city. So I picked up groceries on the way home, and he rarely went to the grocery store with me. But he did learn frugal concepts at home, and he also learned them at school, where they actually gave them a Dave Ramsey course. And he texted me the other day and said he went to the store and his almond milk had gone up a lot. But he saw there were two smaller cartons that equaled the same amount. And when he checked, he could save money by buying the two smaller cartons instead of the larger carton. I was so proud of him for catching that. They try to trick us sometimes because we get used to grabbing a certain size and we don't think about grabbing two of a smaller size and saving money. I've done that before with milk. I've grabbed 4 half gallons of milk instead of 2 gallons because the half gallons were less. So sometimes they try to trick us. So we have to stay on our toes and not just go into cruise control, grabbing the products we always grab. I was behind somebody in the store one day, and they just walked and grabbed a 24-pack of pop and just kept walking. And I looked, and the two 12-packs would have saved them several dollars, but they were used to grabbing that 24-pack and just grabbed it in stride and kept on walking. Another thing that they try to fool us on sometimes is how much per item or how much it is by weight. Broccoli is one of those things where sometimes they're charging you by the pound and sometimes they're charging you by the head. So we really have to make sure that there's not just a pound sign after that really good price we think we're getting, or we may get to the checkout and it costs us double. I also really like to look at how many servings is in one of those bags of like oranges or apples or even tomatoes. I will go and count how many is in there because it makes a difference to me. If it's $4.99 a bag and one has 9 and one has 7, I'm going to get the one that has 9 because that's 2 extra servings. I don't care if they're a little bit smaller. I'm looking at the number of servings versus the cost. Another good example is I went to Aldi the other day to get some bread. I've been on this BLT kick. I told you about that. And I found that I like the thicker sliced bread and I like it toasted. It seems like a lot of the breads have gotten so thin that your fingers almost go right through them even if you toast them. So I wanted the thicker bread because it holds my BLT together. And then when I got there, they only had like the sourdough type. And when I started, yes, counting slices, yes, I did that, I saw that there were enough for 6 sandwiches. And it was about $3.50, which I thought that was kind of high for bread. I usually don't spend that much, but I did want the thicker bread. So I thought, man, am I going to have to pay $3.50? And then I saw these ciabatta rolls. Now I've already eaten three of them, but they come in a six pack. And so what did that sourdough, what would that have made me? It would have made me six sandwiches. There were 12 pieces of bread. There was six of these, same number of servings, ciabatta rolls versus the sourdough bread, and this was a dollar cheaper. So I do look at servings, and I got a nicer sandwich out of this, and I saved a dollar. So sometimes just looking or counting those things can make a big difference. I know that sounds silly, but I've been eating ciabatta rolls all week on my BLT, and let me tell you, it's delicious. And sometimes I might get fooled, but I don't let it get the better of me. For instance, the other day I went and I needed coffee creamer where they had this Carnation coffee creamer, 32 ounces, marked down to $2.44. It says that it is sweetened, and I usually buy like the sweetened Italian cream. So I thought, well, I can use this instead. I'm going to save some money. I got it home, and it's just not sweet. And it makes my coffee taste bad, and I have to add more caramel syrup. And I thought, man, I've just not had a good cup of coffee since I bought this stuff. And then I thought, you know what? I can use this to make ice cream. I don't have to buy the heavy cream to make the ice cream. This can substitute for that. I can use it up. I can still get the kind that I like at the store, and I won't waste any of it. And this is going to be cheaper than buying the heavy cream or even buying the plant cream that I've been using. So I don't let things like this intimidate me. If I pick them up at a good price, I figure out how to use them in another way so that they don't waste. And use those scales that they provide for us in the grocery store. If there's three heads of lettuce in a container, like a romaine, I'm going to feel which one is heaviest, and I'm going to bring that home because I'm going to get more lettuce. If there is 2 pounds of onions, they might be 2 pounds, they might be less than 2 pounds, they might be more than 2 pounds. I get the one that's the heaviest. I'm paying by the package, so why not get the biggest head of celery? Some of those things you can get more just by not grabbing the first one that's on top. Prices are changing quickly, so we really need to stay on top of that. If you're not good at remembering numbers, maybe keep a little tablet and write down how much something cost and where you got it. We've been getting all of our ground sausage at Aldi because it was $2.29 a pound, where some of the other places it was only 12 ounces or it was clear up to $5 a pound. But when we picked it up this last week, it had gone up 50 cents a pound to $2.79. Now, once in a while, I can get the 12-ounce packages for $1.99. So you can bet that I'm going to be on the lookout for some better deals because prices are rapidly changing. Keeping track of those prices and where you buy those things can really save you a bunch of money. As you can see, these are both the same size. This one is a different flavor, which is an unusual flavor that's hard to find, but I don't have to have the special flavor. The normal kind is perfectly fine. This at one store was $3 more than it was at Aldi. So keeping track of those prices can really add up. And I cannot stress enough how knowing what you have can keep you from buying things at inflated costs because you think you need them. I used the last of my tea packets to make sun tea this last week, and I just knew I had another box. But I looked through all of my storage cabinets and I didn't find it. And I just kept telling my husband, I know I bought one and then bought another one. And I know we haven't been through two. So I went through the cabinet again and it had been pushed back and couldn't be seen. And there it was, 24 more 2-quart tea packets. So we are good for the rest of the summer and probably part of next year because we mainly only drink it in the summer. But knowing what you have is so critical to keep you from buying things at those inflated prices because you think you're out of something or you don't know how many you have. So I keep a running list on my phone of what I need, and then I watch for those things to be on sale. And if I don't find them on sale, I either substitute or I make something else. And I always try to stay ahead on like toilet paper, shampoo with the sales so that I don't ever have to pay full price for anything. Keeping that running list so you can always be watching for those sales when they come up can help you stay ahead and not have to pay those inflated prices. I hope that this video has brought you something useful that you can use to save money in your home. I'm so thankful for all of you joining me today, and I hope to see you in the next video.